Hi, I'm Leonie Grandpierre, and I'm the head of science at Equalture. At Equalture, we develop game-based assessments, and my main responsibility at the company is to make sure that they're scientifically validated. Since game-based assessments are still quite a new concept for recruitment professionals, I'm going to use this video to explain a little bit more around the process behind the scientific validation of a game. After a new game has been developed and tested for usability by the science team and our game developers, the validation process can start. The first and most important step in the validation process before launching the game is testing it for construct validity. Construct validity determines whether a test or game measures what it's supposed to measure, so whether it measures the underlying construct. So for example, if we take our problem-solving game, the fairy game, we would compare it to another previously validated assessment of problem-solving ability. In our case, that was the Tower of London task. So let's dive into the logic of this comparison. If someone was a really good problem solver, for example, we would expect them to do well on the game that measures problem solving ability, but also any other validated assessment of problem solving ability. And someone who would be really bad at problem solving, we would expect them to do poorly on both a game and a traditional task measuring problem solving ability. So in this case, that would be the Tower of London task. During the validation studies, we ask our group of participants to play both the game that we want to test and do the traditional task that has already been validated for the same construct. We try to get participants that are representative of a wide range of demographics, so we will get them from different age groups, for example, or also different cultural backgrounds. In the case of the fairy game, for example, which measures problem-solving ability, we let the participants play the fairy game and also do the Tower of London task, the previously validated task of problem-solving ability, and then we checked for patterns in the data. So we checked whether our assumption was correct that the people who do well on the game also do well on the task, and the people who do poorly on the game also do poorly on the task. When this is the case, we can safely assume that both the game and the task measure the same underlying construct and therefore have established construct validity. In our statistical analyses for these games, we take demographic factors into account, so we control for things like age, gender, ethnicity, cultural background, and more. And after the game is launched, we continue testing by replicating the studies. We also continuously test for more demographic effects with larger groups, and we also test for other types of validity, like criterion validity, for example. Criterion validity describes whether or not the game relates to the things that we expect it to relate to. In our case, that would be work performance, for example. All validation reports are publicly available, so if you would like to have a look at them, please contact your contact person at Equalture or start a live chat in our dashboard. They contain a lot more information about our statistical analyses, about our participants, and a lot more.